Okay, start.
Hi, I'm Robin, and I'd like to talk to you again about God's temple. I've talked to you about it a few times already, and I'd like to continue on. This time I want to talk to you about God's temple inside of you. So I'm going to first read from 1 Peter chapter 2, and it's verse 4. Come to the Lord, the living stone, rejected by man as worthless, but chosen by God as valuable. Come as living stones. Let yourselves be used in the building of a spiritual temple, where you will serve as holy priests to offer spiritual and acceptable sacrifices to God through Jesus Christ. For the scripture says, I've chosen a stone which I'm placing as the cornerstone in Zion, and whoever believes in him will never be disappointed. So that's just an introduction to what I want to say. I'm going to read to you now from 1 Corinthians. Chapter 3. And just to put this in context, what has been discussed previously to the part I'm going to read is there's been some argument in the church about, some are following the Apostle Paul, some are following Apollos, and Paul's saying, no, you guys have it all wrong. It's all God's work. It's God's building. It's God's field. You're God's field. You're God's building. And then he goes on to say, surely you know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit lives in you. So if anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him, for God's temple is holy and you yourselves are his temple. So this is one place where God dwells, and he dwells in all of us. In fact, that you, for God's temple is holy and you yourselves are God's temple, that's plural in that sense. And it's the whole group of believers that it's talking about. So God dwells in the whole group of believers. In Canada, where I am, we would translate that and say, for God's temple is holy and you guys are his temple. In the southern states, you translate it and say, for God's temple is holy and y'all are his temple. Now, it is the main thing is the big group of believers, but as individuals, we're also God's temple. The next chapter, 1 Corinthians chapter 6, the section just previous to the verse I'm going to read is talking about sexual immorality. And the verse I'm reading, verse 19, don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who lives in you and was given to you by God? You do not belong to yourselves, but to God. He bought you for a price, so use your bodies for God's glory. So once again, our bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit. And of course, as Christians, we believe in God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Now, it's not like it was in the Old Testament where there was a physical building. Now we have the body of believers. That's where God's temple is. And what's done in the temple, I read in the 1 Peter chapter, or actually 2 Peter chapter, about we're serving as priests and we're worshiping God, and we're just having a dwelling place for God. God is dwelling in us and with us and amongst us. And I like to read now out of Psalm 24. Psalm 24 is it's broken up into two parts, and they're both liturgies. And if you don't go to liturgical church, I'll try to explain that to you. A liturgy is spoken words that are read. The whole congregation reads this, and it's offered up as a worship to God. And I was reading about Psalm 24, and it's believed the second part is a liturgy that was used when the Ark of the Covenant, which symbolized God's presence and where God forgave sins, was brought into the tabernacle, which was the temporary temple, the tent. And the Ark of the Covenant, it symbolized God's presence, and they would take the ark out into battle, and they would bring it back and be victorious and glorious. God had given them victory. And this is a liturgy for God's presence coming into the temple. Fling wide the gates, open the ancient doors, and the great king will come in. Who is the great king? He is the Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord, victorious in battle. Fling wide the gates, open the ancient doors, and the great king will come in. Who is the great king? The triumphant Lord. He is the great king. So what I like to do, I like to think, now it's us that are the temple. And we can say this and ask for God to fill us with his presence, which is what he wants to do. So fling wide the gates, open the ancient doors, and the great king will come in. Who is the great king? He is the Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord victorious in battle.